sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Lilith lurks under doorways, in wells, and in latrines, waiting to seduce men. She is adorned with the ornaments for seduction. Her hair is long and red like the rose, her cheeks are white and red, from her ears hang 6 ornaments, Egyptian cords, and all the ornaments of the land of the east hang from her nape. Her mouth is set like a narrow door, comely in its decor, her tongue is sharp like a sword, her words are smooth like oil, her lips are red like a rose and sweetened by all the sweetness in the world. She is dressed in scarlet and adorned with 40 ornaments less one. Men who sleep alone are especially vulnerable to Lilith. The Zohar also describes Lilith as a female aspect of Leviathan, who has a serpent body. She is Leviathan, the tortuous serpent, the counterpart to the male aspect, Leviathan, the slant serpent. Lilith is the serpent who tempts Eve with the apple of forbidden knowledge in paradise and thus instigates the fall. She also persuades Eve to seduce Adam while she is menstruating and impure. The numerical value of Lilith's name equals the Hebrew word for screech. Thus, Lilith is the demon of screeching, and the princess of screeching, and is personified as a screech owl. In legend, on the Day of Atonement, Lilith spends the day in a screeching battle with Mahalath, a concubine to Samael. They taunt each other so much that the very earth trembles. Also on the Day of Atonement, Lilith goes forth into the desert with 420 legions of her demons, and they march about while she screeches. Lilith is also known as Lady of the Beasts, who rules the wilderness and all beasts, the animal side of human nature. In her guise as the Queen of Sheba, she attempted to seduce King Solomon. He discovered her true nature by having the jinn build a throne room with a floor of glass. Lilith mistook it for water and raised her garments in order to cross it to his throne. Her hairy, bestial legs were revealed in the reflection of the glass. Amulets and incantation bowls traditionally protected new mothers and infants against Lilith. Common amulets were knives and hands inscribed with charms. Some had bells attached. Frogs also protect against her. Male infants were vulnerable for the first week of life, girls for the first 3 weeks. Sometimes a magic circle was drawn around the lying in bed, with a charm inscribed with the names of the 3 angels, Adam and Eve, and the words barring Lilith or protect this newborn child from all harm. Sometimes amulets with such inscriptions were placed in all corners of and throughout the bedchamber. If a child laughed in its sleep, it was a sign that Lilith was present. Tapping the child on the nose made the demon go away. According to lore, men who had nocturnal emissions believed they had been seduced by Lilith during the night and had to say incantations to prevent the offspring from becoming demons. Any seed spilled during sex, even marital sex, is at risk for becoming Lilith.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.